Hello, this is Mark from tradeinform.com and welcome to this video on backtesting a trading strategy using an ATR trailing stop. So on the screen at the moment we have an Excel backtest, and the backtest model is based on the one from my ebook course, How to Backtest a Trading Strategy Using Excel. And this is available in the Amazon Kindle store. There is a link on the screen if you would like more information. The model is also based on my previous video about how to calculate a trailing stop using Excel. Okay, so the trading strategy that we're going to test is quite a nice simple one actually. We're going to use a random entry system. Now this might sound like a crazy way to enter a trading system, and it is obviously because we have no way of knowing what the market is doing at any time. However, the results will show that surprisingly enough, as long as you have good trade management systems in place, you can actually run a profitable trading strategy using random entry. We will be using the euro US dollar pair on the 4 hour time frame for our back test. And we're using 10,000 time periods, which is just over 6 years worth of historic data. Okay, so this is the results page here. We're using the final test. I've already done some scenario testing before recording this video, and the final one that I want to do today is using an ATR multiplier of 4. And while I'm talking, I'll just get this running. Okay, so you'll start to see as I'm talking here that these numbers will get filled in. I'm using quite a simple recorded macro to speed up the process of running multiple backtests. And you'll see that the chart here, which displays the equity curve, will change periodically as a new scenario is tested. If you have a modern laptop or computer, you will find these backtests run a lot quicker than they are doing presently on my particular laptop. Okay, so what are the advantages of using a random entry signal as opposed to any of the myriad other forms of technical or price action entries that we could use? Well, the advantage for me in this particular backtest of using random entry is that we can model multiple scenarios, and there is an advantage to this. What I'm doing is testing one particular value. I'm using a trailing stop and I'm testing multiple runs, hundreds and hundreds of different runs, looking at how different stop loss values, we're using an ATR, the average true range, and our multiplier factor of 4 in this particular case means that every random trade entry will automatically be assigned a trailing stop, a stop loss equivalent to 4 times the ATR. Once we've run through all these different scenarios, we'll have some data that will show how each particular trading stop value responds. This is the only scenario we're changing. Everything else is random, and over enough runs, we should have some data, some results that is statistically significant. And we can see already that the table here is starting to settle down a bit. We've already done quite a lot of tests, and at the moment we've got an average profit of 54,000 as we started with 100,000, so that's a 54% profit. The first one of these is the profit over the 6 year time period. The second one of these is what is sometimes called profit factor. This is calculated by taking the absolute value of the profit of the total winnings divided by the total losses of the trading strategy. You can see that in this scenario, in the scenarios that I've tested, it is highest when we're using a tight stop loss, a stop loss of just 1x the ATR. You can see in these later ones, it's not much greater than 1. However, we still have quite a high profit, 56. Excel has just moved it away. We've got quite a high profit, 56% profit over the time period. This is pretty respectable. The reason why we're getting a low profit factor is because of the calculation. This is an average of all the different scenarios. It is the mean average of the profit factors. What it's not taking into account is the times when the strategy is really profitable. So we will make in these higher ATRs, higher trading stops, we were much more likely to get very high profits. Whereas when we look at the tighter trading stops, we could well be more consistent, but we're going to make lower maximum amounts of profit. And it's just finished the run there. And we can see that the results are pretty consistent, really, over the three ATRs. You can find that a trading stop just using a random entry over 50 tests each of somewhere around 500 trades for each. We're having a lot of trade entries here. We certainly could do more, and these results will no doubt change again. However, we've got something at the moment that is quite reasonably statistically significant, and to my satisfaction proves that a trading stop is a good way to close a trading strategy using the Euro USD as an example, under the 4 hour. And the subsequent videos that I'm going to record will look at seeing if we can improve this profitability by using technical analysis, using technical indicators and price action to get better trade entries. If you'd like more information about using Excel to backtest trading strategies and about the financial markets and economics in general, please go to www.tradeinformed.com.